नमस्कार दोस्तों, वेलकम इन आवर ऑनलाइन स्टडी ऑफ मैथमेटिक्स।
दोस्तों, मैथ एक ऐसा सब्जेक्ट है कि आप इसके जितना नजदीक जाएंगे, जितना करीब जाएंगे, ये अपने आप में उतना ही इंटरेस्ट आपको बढ़ाएगा। इसलिए मैथ से कभी भी दूरी मत बनाएं। चलिए, आज के इस वीडियो में हम क्लास 10 के मैथमेटिक्स के चैप्टर 7 में कोऑर्डिनेट ज्योमेट्री के विषय में चर्चा करेंगे। तो आइए हमारे इस वीडियो का आनंद उठाइए और इसे समझने की पूरी कोशिश कीजिए। दोस्तों, रेनी दे कार्तिक, एवरीबडी नो अबाउट दिस पर्सन। दिस पर्सन इज नोन एज फादर ऑफ कोऑर्डिनेट ज्योमेट्री एंड ही गिव्स द कॉन्सेप्ट। रेनी दे कार्ते द ग्रेट फ्रेंच मैथमेटिशियन, ही सॉल्व द प्रॉब्लम ऑफ डिस्क्राइबिंग द पोजिशन ऑफ ए पॉइंट इन ए प्लेन। The system used for describing the position of a point in a plane is known as the Cartesian system. So, दोस्तों, रेनी दे कार्ते के नाम पर ही ये कार्टेशियन सिस्टम कहा जाता है। किसी भी पॉइंट की पोजीशन को जानने के लिए जो एक प्लेन में है उसका सिद्धांत रेनी दे कार्ते ने दिया था, इसीलिए इनको हम मैथ्स का जनक कहते हैं। नाउ कोऑर्डिनेट्स, व्हाट अबाउट द कोऑर्डिनेट? एवरीबडी नो ओरिजिन एंड दिस इज द एक्स एक्सिस एंड दिस वन इज वाई एक्सिस। द इंटरसेक्शन पॉइंट इज नोन एज ओरिजिन एंड जनरली डिनोटेड बाई ओ। सो दिस इंटरसेक्शन पॉइंट ऑफ एक्स एक्सिस एंड वाई एक्सिस इज नोन एज ओरिजन। सो दीज आर टू एक्सिस। एक्स दिस इज पॉजिटिव डायरेक्शन ऑफ एक्स एक्सिस एंड दिस इज द नेगेटिव डायरेक्शन ऑफ एक्स एक्सिस। मीन्स वी इंडिकेट हियर नेगेटिव नंबर्स एंड दिस इज द पॉजिटिव डायरेक्शन ऑफ वाई एक्सिस। मीन्स इंडिकेटेड द पॉजिटिव नंबर्स एंड दिस वन इज नेगेटिव डायरेक्शन ऑफ वाई एक्सिस। हियर वी इंडिकेटेड नेगेटिव नंबर्स। नाउ क्वाड्रेंट्स, देयर आर फोर क्वाड्रेंट्स, एवरीबडी नो हियर। दिस इज फर्स्ट क्वाड्रेंट एंड दिस वन इज सेकेंड क्वाड्रेंट एंड हियर इज थर्ड क्वाड्रेंट एंड नाउ दिस वन इज नोन एज फोर क्वाड्रेंट। दीज फोर क्वाड्रेंट डिवाइडेड बाई दीज एक्सिस, दैट इज एक्स एक्सिस एंड वाई एक्सिस। नाउ फर्स्ट क्वाड्रेंट डिनोटेड पॉजिटिव कोऑर्डिनेट्स, दैट इज एक्स कोऑर्डिनेट इज पॉजिटिव एंड वाई कोऑर्डिनेट इज ऑल्सो पॉजिटिव। एंड सेकेंड कोऑर्डिनेट इंडिकेटेड एक्स कोऑर्डिनेट एज नेगेटिव एंड वाई कोऑर्डिनेट इज पॉजिटिव एंड देन थर्ड कोऑर्डिनेट बोथ साइन आर नेगेटिव। मीन्स एक्स कोऑर्डिनेट एंड वाई कोऑर्डिनेट बोथ आर नेगेटिव एंड दिस इज फोर्थ क्वाड्रेंट, एक्स कोऑर्डिनेट इज पॉजिटिव एंड वाई कोऑर्डिनेट इज नेगेटिव। So these are quadrant and the sign of quadrant you have to learn. And keep in mind that always plus is present just near to y-axis in these three quadrant, but quadrant third is already negative, that is x and y both are negative coordinates and other Or keep in mind this plus 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 just lies nearest to the y-axis. So 1, 0 lies in which quadrant? First or second? Which one? 1, 0 lies. This is the question. 1, 0 lies in which quadrant? Non. किसी भी क्वाड्रेंट में नहीं होगा. पॉइंट्स विच लाई ऑन द एक्स एक्सिस डू नॉट लाई इन एनी क्वाड्रेंट बिकॉज एक्स कोऑर्डिनेट इज 1 मींस दिस पॉइंट इज लाइज जस्ट दिस पोजिशन. सो दिस इज नॉन लाइज इन एनी क्वाड्रेंट. नाउ कोऑर्डिनेट, फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल वी इंडिकेटेड दीज एक्सिस एंड द नंबर्स नेगेटिव एंड पॉजिटिव डायरेक्शन विथ नेगेटिव एंड पॉजिटिव डायरेक्शन. Now, what you represent this point? X-axis is 2, so this is 2, and y-axis is 1. Distance from the y-axis is 1, so the coordinate of this point is 2, 1. Now, second point, you can see that x-coordinate is negative 3, that is minus 3, and y-coordinate is minus 2, so we will indicate it is minus 3, comma minus 2, and minus 3 is known as abscissa, and this is ordinate. Okay, second coordinate is known as ordinate, and first coordinate is known as abscissa. Now what is the position of this point? Clear? Y axis is 2, lies between 2 and 3, that is 2.5, and x distance from the x-axis is 4. So we can see that this is 4, 2.5. Distance from the x-axis is plus 4, and distance from the y-axis just lies between minus 2 and minus 3. So we can say that minus 2.5. So the position of this point is 4, minus 2.5. Now the distance formula. How can you generate distance formula? Let us, this is the axis, x-axis and y-axis, and this is a point P having coordinate x1 and y1, and this is the point Q having coordinate x2 and y2. Now we will find here distance between these two points P, Q. So let us here, there's the distance from the x-axis PQN is a right angle triangle. So first of all, we will construct it as PQN. This is a right angle triangle. In this, let us, this is the distance from the x-axis x2, and this is the y x1. Therefore, distance from this is x2 minus x1. Similarly, whole distance is y2 and this one is y1. Therefore, remaining is y2 minus y1. Now, using the Pythagoras theorem, that is PQ square equal to PN square plus QN square. Okay? How can you say that? By the Pythagoras theorem, this is the hypotenuse. Therefore, PQ square equal to PN square plus QN square. And that PN square is how much? PN. PN mean x2 minus x1. So we will write x2 minus x1 whole square. And this distance, that is QN, how much? Y2 minus y1. So we will write here y2 minus y1 whole square, because this is square. After that, taking square root, we will get PQ equal to under root x2 minus x1 whole square plus y2 minus y1 whole square. So this is known as distance formula, and you will keep in mind this formula, that is, this is the distance formula, and you can also write this as x1 minus x2 whole square plus y1 minus y2 whole square. So the answer never changed, because this is the square, so sign will not change. Therefore, we can write in both form, either x2 minus x1 or x1 minus x2 whole square. Similarly, y1 minus y2 whole square or y2 minus y1 whole square. this gives the same value. So this formula is known as distance formula. Okay, I think that the concept is clear for the distance formula, and for driving the distance formula we will construct this figure, and taking this whole distance is x2 from the x-axis from the origin, and similarly this is the distance x1 from the origin, that is y-axis, and remaining distance we can calculate, that is x2 minus x1. Similarly, this distance is y1, let us we will take, this is y1, and whole distance from the x-axis to this point Q is y2, then the distance is y2 minus y1, this is the distance Qn. Now using the Pythagoras theorem, in this right angle triangle we can write hypotenuse, that is PQ square, equal to PN square, that is base square, plus LTQ square, that is QN square, and substitute the value. PN is x2 minus x1 whole square, and this is y2 minus y1, so we will get this distance formula. Now distance from origin, how can you calculate distance from origin? Distance of x comma y from the origin is x minus 0, because the coordinate of origin is always 0 comma 0, so x and the origin is 0, so x minus 0 whole square plus y minus y, what kya formula kya hota hai, y2 minus y1, so hum kya likhenge, y2 means this y and y1 means origin 0, so y minus 0 whole square means we will get under root x square plus y square. So this is the distance from the origin. Okay, and you will get this type of question in examination, that is multiple choice question, and some option is given, so you will select the distance from the origin is under root x square plus y square. This is the now application of distance formula. Here is a question: find the distance between the points A 2,3 and B 4,1. So these are coordinate of two points A and B. So we will find here distance between these two points. So dear, here is given that we will write it as here x1 equal to 2 and y1 equal to 3 from this coordinate. Abscissa is 2 and ordinate is 3. So we will write is x1 equal to 2, y1 equal to 3. And for the point B, x2 equal to 4 and y2 equal to 1. Since we know that distance formula, that is distance between AB, we can write it as AB equal to under root x2 minus x1 whole square plus y2 minus y1 whole square. Now substitute this value in this formula, then we will get what? X2 means 4 minus x1 means 2, and this is a whole square, plus y2 means 1 and minus 3, this is again whole square. On simplifying this we will get 4 minus 2 means 2 whole square plus 1 minus 3 means minus 2 whole square. On squaring this we will get 2 square means 4, and again minus 2 square means once again 4. So 4 plus 4 means how much? This is 8,
and 8 is written as 4 into 2 and square root of 4 is 2 and under root 2. And you can write it as units. So this is the answer of this question. So this is the application of distance formula. You will first of all consider the given coordinate as x1, y1, x2, y2 and substitute all the values in the given formula. Then you will find the distance. And here is units is not given centimeter, like meter, like kilometer. So you will write here units. I think that application of distance formula will be clear. Next question. Name the type of quadrilateral formed by the given points -1, -2, 1, 0, -1, 2 and -3, 0. So which type of quadrilateral formed with these points? How can you identify? So here is once again application of distance formula. First of all, for this question, we will find the distance between AB, means find the all sides of quadrilateral. Let us these points for a quadrilateral formed by points A, B, C, D. Means a quadrilateral required 4 points. So first of all, we will let first point as a coordinate A and second one let us B. This is the coordinate of point B and third point let us, this is the coordinate of point C and fourth one let us, it is the coordinate of the points D. Means A, B, C, D, these are vertices of quadrilateral. So first of all, we will find here the length of the side AB for that quadrilateral. After that, the length of the side BC and then CD. After that, DA. And then we will also find the diagonals. And then we will observe which type of quadrilateral formed by these points. So, since we know that the distance formula D equal to under root x2 minus x1 whole square plus y2 minus y1 whole square. This is the distance formula. Now, D means first of all we will find here AB, first side. So let for first side, AB means this is x1, this is y1. Keep in your mind. And this is x2 and this is y2. So you substitute this value in the given formula. If x2 is 1, then you will put here 1 and x1 is -1. So minus and this minus means you will get +1 and whole square. After that this plus sign and y2. y2 means here is 0 because this is x1 y1, this is x2 y2. So y2 is 0 and minus, again here is minus, so minus minus plus, and y1 is 2. So you substitute this value and this is whole square. So what you get? You will get for on simplifying this, 1 plus 1 means 2 whole square, and this is again 0 plus 2 means 2 whole square. So what you get? You will get here my 2 square means 4, and again 2 square means 4, that is 4 plus 4 means under root this is 8 units. Okay, now you will find next after that side AB. next side is BC. So our requirement to find the side BC. For BC, you will once again take this x1 for the point B, x1, y1, and this is x2, y2. Once again, you substitute the value. So x2 is here minus 1, and x1 is once again 1, and here is negative sign, so you put minus 1 whole square plus y2 here is 2, and y1 is 0. So 2 minus 0 whole square, what you get for this? You will get this is minus 1 minus 1 minus 2 whole square. Minus 2 whole square means 4. Minus is converted into the positive sign, and 2 minus 0 means 2. And 2 square means once again you will get 4. So 4 and 4 how much? This is 8. So you will write under root 8 units. Okay, you can write here units, and this is also units. Now after that BC, you will get which side? CD. Then now we will find here CD. Now this is the distance formula, and now you take here this is x1, y1, and this is x2, y2. So x2 is minus 3 and x1 is minus 1. So you put here minus 3 and minus 1 whole square. So what you get for this? You will get plus this is y2 and this is y1. Y2 means how much? Y2 means 0 and minus y1 means 2. So again you will get this is whole square. After on simplifying minus 3 minus 1 minus 4. Minus 4 whole square means how much? 16. And this is minus 2 whole square means how much? This is okay dear. See once again here. This is minus 3 and this is minus 1. When you put here this minus 1, then minus and minus just convert into the plus sign. So minus 3 plus 1, how much? What you get? Minus 2. And minus 2 whole square means 4. Minus is converted into plus sign. And minus 2 again whole square. 0 minus 2 means minus 2. Minus 2 whole square means once again 4. So what you get? 4 and 4 under root 8. So this is once again you will find the next side, that is CD. Now we will find other side, that is D. After that CD, DA. So we will find here DA. How can you find DA? Simple, we will find as CD equal to under root what? This is x1, this is y1, and this is x2 and y2. X2 means minus 1 and minus, and x1 is minus 3. So minus minus, here is minus, minus minus plus, and whole square plus x2 means this is minus 2 and minus 2 minus 0. So you will put here minus 2 minus 0 whole square. So what you get for this? You will get minus 3 plus 3. Minus 1 plus 3 means 2. 2 whole square means 4. Okay. And minus 2 whole square means again 4. So 4 and 4 how much? You will get 8 units. This is also units. Now 4 sides you have find. After that you will find the diagonals for a quadrilateral. If ABCD is a quadrilateral, let us, this is quadrilateral ABCD, any type of quadrilateral, we will don't know which type of quadrilateral, and these are diagonals. Let us, this is A, B, C and D, then what is the diagonal? AC and BD. So our requirement AC. First of all, we will find here A and C. A is this point and C is this point. So let us, this is x1, y1, and this is x2 and y2. X2 means minus 1. So you substitute here x2 minus 1. Okay, and this is x1. So again minus 1. So minus minus plus whole square plus x y2 means 2 and y1 means minus 2. So what you get? Minus 2 and this is again minus 2. So minus minus. See here, this is y, this is x1, y1, x2, y2. Y2 means plus 2. So we will put here plus 2. Okay. And this is minus 2. So minus and this negative sign for formula. Minus minus plus. So this is whole square. Now 1 and minus 1, this is cancelled out. 0. 0 square means 0. And 2 plus 2 means 4. 4 square means how much? 16. 4 square means 16. And 16 means you can write this is only 4 units. Okay. Now our requirement next diagonal is BD. So BD we will find here. BD equal to under root for B and D. This is B and this is D. Let us, this is x1, y1 and this is x2, y2. So x2 is minus 3 and minus 1. X1 is 1. So you put here 1 whole square and plus x2 means 0. Sorry, y2 is 0 and y1 is also 0. So 0 minus 0 whole square. So what you get? Minus 3 minus 1. Both are negative. Means minus 4 whole square. Minus 4 whole square means 0, 0 means this is 0. So minus 4 square means how much? 16. Positive 16. And positive 16 can be written as 4, because this is root 16 and the root, so square root of 16 is 4. Now you will observe here, therefore you observe here, since AB is under root 8, BC is under root 8, CD is root 8, and here DA, sorry, this is DA, not CD, this is DA. D is also under root 8. So you will write here AB equal to BC equal to CD equal to what? DA. Otherwise you can write it as AD. Since all the sides are equal, then what you get the conclusion? And diagonal AC equal to BD. Why? Because AC is 4 units and BD is also 4 units. This is equal. So this condition hold in which quadrilateral? Means all sides are equal and diagonals are all equal. Sides are equal and diagonals are equal. Since diagonals and all sides are equal, all sides are equal and diagonals are also equal, therefore what? ABCD is A, quadrilateral ABCD is A square. 100% this is a square, because this property hold in the quadrilateral, that is square, in which all sides are equal and diagonals are also equal. So given points are form a square, and this is the answer of this question. So I think that the concept is clear. How can you apply the distance formula and how can you identify that given quadrilateral which type okay?
Thank you dear, watching my video up to last, but not forget to like, share and comment it and subscribe my channel so that you get my video first of all.